friends, welcome to Future Perfect Tech Shorts. I'm Tony Velasquez. The controversial death of a teenage boy allegedly framed and killed by Caloocan police in an anti-drug operation has revived previous proposals to equip policemen with body cameras. In 2016, Muntinlupa Representative Rufy Biazon filed such a bill with the aim of deterring possible police abuses during anti-crime operations. This week, Senator Sherwin Gatchalian said he would also file a bill requiring the use of body cams to record footage of any police operation from start to finish. And with us in the studio to discuss how body cams can help curb police abuses, Congressman Rufy Biazon, and with us also Stephanie D., a distributor of Zumi body cameras. Kong and Stephanie, thank you very much for coming over to Future Perfect. Well, who knew body cameras would be so acceptable to the PNP now? Before, General De La Rosa said, let's not make it a priority.
Yes, yeah. When we first introduced the bill last year, there was kind of a resistance from the PNP.
But because now, of the cost?
Well, they mentioned the cost. But now there's public clamor for more accountability, then I think they're changing their minds.
I have to ask, because there must have been some research done before filing a bill like this. In the experience of other countries, maybe like the U.S., who also has a bad police record in some states, has the use of body cams helped to prevent further police abuses?
Well, the expansion of the program from one state to another would show that there's been a measure of success. As we know, U.S. police authorities have been plagued with issues of abuse and
excessive force.
The use of excessive force. So the use of body cams by policemen, I think, has given them an edge in addressing these issues of abuse.
Now, I've got to ask Congressman Rufy if you've seen a body cam actually in use anywhere in the Philippines.
Well, I haven't seen an actual body cam similar to what the U.S. Police departments use.
Yeah.
I didn't know that there were products already available here in the country. So we were actually looking for models that would be suitable for use by the Philippine National Police.
Now, the problem with attempting to get the police use body cams would be the concern that they might just switch off the body cam if they didn't want anything recorded. Obviously, we've seen the case of the raid of the home of the Paruhinog family in Ozamiz, where the CCTV cameras in the house were actually disabled before the operation took place.
Well, of course, we will be instituting rules and procedures with regard to the use of the body cams. And you can't escape that possibility of them turning it off.
Mm-hmm.
But it would also point to them as being suspicious action on their part. It's better than not having a video record at all.
If I remember correctly, I think the bill that was recently proposed by Senator Gatchalian provides for a penalty for policemen who don't record the actual operation, especially if it results to the death or injury of a person in an anti-crime operation. Do you have anything similar in your bill?
Well, our approach is to make it part of the standard operating procedure of the PNP. And of course, any violation of their SOPs has a corresponding penalty. We're open to considering additional or special penalties with regard to the body cam use.
Now, of course, legislation requires budgetary support. How much would you have thought it would have required to equip the entire PNP with body cams?
Well, as I've been doing research, costs of body cams in the U.S. range from $800 to $1,200 per piece.
Okay.
I don't know how it would cost here, but we can use that as a benchmark. I'm not envisioning it as a one-time purchase for everyone.
Yeah. It could be done in stages.
Yeah, we can do it in stages. We can initially require
sa mga drug-prone areas muna.
Yung operating units that do these kinds of operations.
PIDEA.
Unlike in the U.S., I think they require all policemen to carry, even the ordinary foot patrol policemen. But we can do it in stages. In fact, in my bill, it provides for a two-year period for it to become a standard equipment for all policemen.
Okay.
So we can start with the operating units, such as those that are tasked to do anti-drug operations. So staging it would help us manage the cost.
Yeah, okay. Now let's have an idea of how a body cam actually works and maybe how much it would cost, you know, in the Philippine setting. Stephanie D is with us. You're a distributor of a brand of body cameras called Zumi. Is that
yes,
right?
Yes, correct.
Zumi. Is Zumi the only body camera that could be available locally, or do you have competitors?
Currently, we do have competitors, a few bigger ones and some generic competitors.
So generic. So, pwedeng tataka ng kung ano na lang. Anong gusto mong tataka? Tokhang body cam.
Yes. Oh,
I'm going to hold it up. I'm just going to show our audience what it may look like. So, this is the actual unit. It's in a cradle, which I suppose
it's
is the charging,
charger, yes.
charging base. So, the body cam itself, it's a pretty thick unit. Para siyang for people much younger than me, parang pocket pager. Ano ba yon? Pocket pager, sabi ng mga millennial. Pocket pager, ano yon? So, what are the specs of the Zumi body cam? Stephanie, okay.
This specific model is built in with 32 gigabytes of memory. So, that's about 9 hours of recording.
Continuous recording at
HD resolution.
HD plan.
Yeah, okay. HD. It also is waterproof, IP67.
Okay.
So basically, submerge 1 meter for 30 minutes, okay. Kaya pa. Drop proof of 2 meters.
Okay.
And other features it has is it's password protected. So I think one of the things that you mentioned with not recording or maybe deleting the videos, at least deleting the videos part, you can not have that problem.
But what if the user himself wants to delete the videos?
You can't do it here. So it has the administrator has a password to set, so they can delete it on the computer.
It's a safeguard for the user not to be able to delete any of the contents unless i-approved ng administrator.
Yes.
So kailangan ko na rin si General Bato ang administrator.
Kailangan may password ni General Bato bago mo ma-delete.
Password is I will kill you. So it can record continuously for 9 hours. HD, paano pa dilim?
It also has IR sensors.
Infrared.
So, infrared. So at meaning? Night, you can turn it off, turn it on, and then it will record in black and white. Like, same as the CCTVs that you see currently.
Kasi di ba, Kong, sabihin ng police, sa hearing, kunwari, naumpisa na, sir, I used my body cam, but there was no light because Miralco did not switch on the lights.
And
so, sir, madilim. So, puro anino lang nakikita mo. Paano ngayon gagawin? Useless. Di ba? Parang may palusot eh.
Well, that's why one of the good features of this is the IR.
Kailangan. Kahit madilim,
that should be a requirement.
Able to capture images in low light. Magiging black and white lang ha.
Yes.
Ayun. Kasi parang sabihin na naman, sir, hindi po yun yung bata na kinakalagkan. Naka-long pants po yun. Naka-shorts po yung bata. Eh, sabihin kitong-kito, uy, kita naman naka... Yung bang camera, pwedeng gawing long pants yung naka-short pants?
You mean edit the video?
Oo, parang augmented reality?
Well, if you have the password to download the video, to edit it.
Pwedeng lagyan ng long pants. Okay, I'm just kidding. Let's show our audience something that you recorded on the Zumi body camera before we went on air. It's on Stephanie's laptop. So if you may, just point the laptop towards the camera. There, we can see it. This was recorded... at night, right? Just let me see if I can tilt that so we can remove the glare. There you go. And this was recorded outside. It's a little bright as well outside the ABS-CBN studios. So steady rin siya pala, even if you're walking, you know, hindi siya maalog. So you can actually get a good view kahit siguro tumatakbo pa yung tao wearing the body cam. At this point, is the camera recording in color or in black and white?
It's in color.
It's in color now kasi maliwanag naman. And does it also record audio?
Yes, it does.
Okay. So, ang importante din dito, because you need both video and audio.
Yes.
Oo, because yung audio, maririnig mo din. Mamaya, nagbibigay ng instruction yung police. Oh, hawakan mo to. Iputok mo. Oh, takbo ka na. Tapos biglang may sisigaw. Pusila-pusila! Do you know what pusila-pusila means?
Ako na.
Yes. Alam mo yan. You know your history back from 1983. because those were the final words that
I was
heard
in high school then.
Before Ninoy Aquino was actually killed on the tarmac of the old airport. So, Stephanie, once you record it, and you can transfer it to a laptop.
Yes.
Okay. And then, sa laptop, pwede na burahin.
Yes.
Hindi na siya password protected.
Well, when you connect the body cam to the laptop, you have to enter your password first.
Before you can copy
the videos.
Okay. So, importante dito, Kong, di ba? I think we were discussing the problem with the implementation of the body cam proposal is not just to actually record the videos, but to store the videos.
Yes. Yeah. The problems encountered by the U.S. now is the cost of storage.
Yeah.
To the point that they're looking at alternatives to the equipment because it's costing them a huge amount of money just to store the video.
Yeah.
Like the policy is keeping it for a period of 6 months before you delete it.
6 months lang?
Yes.
Eh, dito, tagot-tagot bago magkaroon ng trial. Kung may trial man.
No, if it becomes part of a case, then the storage is going to be
extended.
Yeah. But for the regular videos that are taken, it's the storage is 6 months.
Okay, so you don't foresee na parang you might need that again even after 6 months. You know, you shouldn't delete it.
Well, the idea there is within that 6 month period, if a case is going to prosper, then it should be available.
Okay, so Stephanie, how much was this?
The standard package with the 32 gig with GPS is 7,100.
Standard.
So,
meron bang special
upgraded package? Yeah. If you need the auxiliary cam, since you mentioned na it's a bit bulky.
Yeah.
Auxiliary cam, so it's more hidden. Yeah. At least this, kunyari, you can put on your belt and this is na lang yung
And then
nakita.
Use that, wear that on your vest or
your
uniform.
With this, it more or less is about 9,000. And then if you need bigger storage, because we do have body cams with 64 gig up to 128 gig of memory.
But that's already built into the body cam itself. Okay, you don't have like an external recorder. Hindi na kailangan ng ganun.
No, it's built in. From the onset, you have to let us know that you need, like, say, let's say, 128 gig.
So may bidding naman dapat kong?
Definitely.
If ever na maipasa,
the procurement process.
Hindi pwedeng direct negotiation.
We have laws in place for that.
Okay, procurement. So, ito, mukha bang pwede nang pumasa ito?
It would have to undergo
you need
test,
field trials.
Of course. And that would be beyond me.
Kasi alam mo kung bakit? O, di sinabi ni Stephanie, kaya nito mag-record sa dilim. Kaya niya mag-survive ng 2-meter drop. Eh, kung sabihin ng police, ay, so, boss, 2.5 meters pa nahulog niya. Sa tuwid pa. Sa tubig pa na kumukulo. Paano yan? Daming palusot, no? Ako naisip ko na
They can think of a lot of ways
to give excuses. Stephanie, kaya ba yun? Lumulubog sa kumukulong tubig?
No. Boiling water, no.
Okay. Tip na po yan, eh. Grabe. May tip pa bigla. Kung Rufy, thanks very much for coming over. And hopefully,
so
maybe...
If I may just add one point.
Sure, sure.
Last year, the issue raised by the chief PNP is that the cost.
The cost.
But you know, for this year, 2018, they're asking for a budget of 900 million pesos.
To go to where? Procurement?
To do Operation Tokhang Part 2. Okay, so
pero what
I think they can take it from that budget.
Pero ano ba ang coverage ng 900 million? Baka naman
well, personally, I have yet to hear them explain it. Where we're doing our budget hearings
now.
So that's where we will be coming in and asking them, saan nyo gagamitin yung 900 million? Why not use this?
Yeah. Kabaong. Formalin. Okay, my floor director wants to be on the body cam. Mamaya. Better body cam than body bag, no?
Yes.
Diba? Stephanie, thanks also for coming over. I'm sorry, we didn't get the name of your company. What is the name of the company distributing Zoomy?
Zoomy PH.
It's called Zoomy PH. So it's a local distributor of Zoomy PH. Thank you very much for coming over to Future Perfect.
Thank you very much.